morning. Thank you, Babu, for the nice introduction. So Babu has already covered the history of refraction. So I will be a little going more details, what is spectacle frame lens and what is technology innovations. So I have no financial interest. So I have been teaching optometry for the last 30, 35 years for diploma optometry, BSc optometry, graduate, PG level, DMB level. I also examined for all these courses. And I have found that the knowledge about refraction among PGs is just average only. But the public, especially the E generation, younger generation, they are very much aware about the spectacles, what is available in the market. So they are buying spectacles from the market by net. Mainly Lenskart is the main players in that area. So a general knowledge, what is available in the market is essential for all consultant. Because the younger generation will come and ask some questions. You should be able to answer to these questions. So this my talk is only a general outline what is available in the market. So we have written a book on refraction, state of the art 21st century. It is going to be published by the JP Bade soon. So I will be talking mainly what is refraction clinic and what is spectacle selection. And spectacle indolence will be dealt with Dr. Radharamanan. And setting up of optical shop and ethical aspect will be dealt by Dr. Nimal Frederick. So when the patient comes to your hospital or clinic, is your hospital clean? Are your staff polite? Does your equipment look sophisticated? Is your hospital or dispensing unit or refraction unit is computerized? They will look all these factors. So this is our time old refraction, our testing unit. So we have all that old trial frame, trial set, all the catometer, all these things. That's all we all last 20, 30 years we are used to it. Now see what is the new refraction unit or refraction room. So all these projectors, four-opter, computer, auto refractometer, all the instruments are there. So previously we all used this trial set for the cross with the cross cylinder, find out the axis and everything. Now with the four-opter, you can have the accurate measurement of the spherical, cylindrical axis. All these things are possible with a four-opter. So our patients will be highly impressed by seeing all these things. So the four-opter has four dials, one for spherical, one for cylinder, and one for find out the power of the cylinder, and final fourth one for finding out the axis. So now there's a digital four-opter. So there is no need of turning the knob. Everything is computerized. It is connected to the laptop and everything. So digitally, they will select what is the power, what is the axis, everything. So digital four-opter is now available. And a digital chart projector is also available. Testing, you can adjust the distance of 4 meter, 5 meter, or 8 meter. Depends upon your testing unit, testing room. And the auto chart projector is available with the digital monitoring, so features both fully automated, programmable, and random access chart selection. So after cataract surgery, patient or bystander will be insisting on to seeing the last 7th line or 8th line. With this projector, you can hide the last 2 or 3 lines, depends upon your outcome of your cataract surgery, so that is also available. So computer eye testing, autorefractometer is a mandatory nowadays because to find out whether there is any cylinder power and what is axis. Of course, you can subjectively, you can correct it. So we should have a change from the old ancient clinic or your refraction unit. You should change the modern refraction unit, refraction chair and everything. Of course, there is a past and this is a present. And the outpatient, our patient will be highly impressed by seeing all these gadgets. Of course, you should buy all these instruments, at least AR, four-opter, digital densometer, slit lamp, pachymetry, etc. At least all these essential instruments should be purchased, then only it will be possible. So this is a display of all these instruments. So we have to introduce digital eye examination in your unit. So when the patient comes in your consultation room, they have a wow effect. Of course, they will give the, if they are coming with 100 rupees, they will definitely give you 200 rupees after seeing this unit. Now I will go into what is available regarding glasses, spectacle, and lens. So now there's lifestyle dispensing. Every patient has a unique lifestyle. So it combines the self-image, occupation of the customer, lesser activities, personal values. So they are buying spectacle depends upon their occupation or need, or this part of dress code now. So the lifestyle dispensing nowadays we are practicing. So we have an essential role. Patient sees the world through their spectacle lenses. So as an eye specialist, we have a vital role to play. You are the expert to recommend the right spectacle and the lens for the patient for that occupation. So how can we satisfy our patients? So the clarity of vision that depends upon a refraction, the power view calculator, subjective refraction. The quality of vision mainly based on the material for the lens you are using. A spherical lens should be prescribed. The brand nowadays, the younger generation, they are not, everybody want a branded lens only. They want the best price, they are not least bothered, especially IT people. A good spectacle lens ensure better visual experience and make him happy. So a happy and satisfied patient do come by. Of course, they will come with their relatives or friends. And that's the best reward you can get as an eye specialist. So what is available as a spectacle varieties? It can be single vision for refractive error, myopia, hypermetropia. It can be a reading glass for presbyopia. It can be a bifocal glasses for presbyopia. Or it can be a multifocal or progressive spectacle. Or it can be sunglasses. Or sunglasses with power incorporated into that. Or occasional spectacles. The vocational use spectacles mainly half-eye reading spectacles, safety spectacles, swimming goggles, sports glasses, driving mask, computer glass, welding goggles, etc. So what are the frame varieties? The half-eye reading frame, that is the most common half-eye reading frame, because very cheap, only 100 to 200 rupees only. Then full rim, that means 360 degree, there will be rim will be there. Or rimless means there's a three piece only, two leg and a nose bridge only. That is a little expensive. Then half rim or supra frame, that means it is upper part only, there's a frame, lower part there's no frame, there's only thread only. Or there's a special type like flip-on lens, spectacle, etc. So regarding the frame materials, so time old was the metal alloy. So the corrosion is the problem. Then came the shell or carbon frame. Now the younger generation, new generation, they want only shell or carbon frame only. In between came the stainless steel and aluminum. This is lightweight, but it is now gone out of market because of the high corrosion. Now the trend is for middle age and older generation, it is trend is for titanium. That is lightweight, high strength, and no corrosion. Of course, prices will be double than a metal frame. And in between, there is a status symbol, gold was there, 9 to 14 carat, because of the high cost of gold, now no, I think nobody is going for a gold frame. So people are so fond of eco-friendly frame, and that is also now available. 95% recycled material they are using. Eco means earth conscious optics. So they use recycled material, can be disposable also. So what are the lens varieties? As you know, single vision, that is for myopia and hypermetropia. Then bifocals can be two type, that is a crypto, that means upper part will be round. Then can be D type, that means upper part will be flat. You get a little more area. In between, there is a trifocals came, but now gone out of market because of the appearance of the multifocal or progressive lens. Now the market, 70-80% is taken by progressive glasses. What are the lens materials? The common lens material, most common cheap, is the crown glass. Highly transparent, scratch resistant, only probably little weight. And it is comparatively cheaper also. Then came the CR39 or Columbia Resin 39. It's a research product of USA. It is made of allyl diglycol carbonate. It is excellent optics, less easily broken, lightweight, thermosetting, and only problem can have a scratches in between. So you need a scratch coating. So then came the polycarbonate with a high refractive index of 1.5. Thin, light, strong, thermoplastic, may need a scratch resistant coating. Then came the high index lenses, so the refractive index more than 1.6. So that will reduce the thickness and weight of the glass. And there's an option of photochromic also. Photochromic is color changing achieved through silver highlight crystals when you're exposed to sunlight or UV radiation. So that will be a UV protection. When you're exposed to light, the color will be going on changing. So when you lens material, these are the properties you have to look into. What is the material, whether the glass, CR39 or polycarbonate, what is the refractive index, what is the specific gravity, what is the Abbe value, And what is the reflection when the light falls on the lens, how much reflection it is taking place? What is transmittance or how much it is UV protection to UVA and UVB? Based on this, now the best lens now available is the polycarbonate with 1.58 refractive index or 1.6 MR6 or 1.66 or MR7 or MR8. These are the best lenses now available in the market. So plastic lens is usually the optical shop fellow will say you can have a plastic lens. Plastic lens means CR39, Columba resin 39. Available refractive index is 1.49 to 1.74. Advantage is a good optics, lightweight. Safer than glass lens because usually it will not break. Unlimited designs are available. You can have all the coatings, tinting can be done. And the photochromic option is also available. Only problem, difficult to drill. When you're going for a three-piece frame, you can drill it, but in time, sometimes it could break. You should take the spectacle in on your face and putting taking out should be with both hands. Otherwise, you are holding only one hand, means you can break at that point. So that's a problem with the CR39. So CR39 is not the best choice for rimless frames or three-piece frames. You should go for a polycarbonate, then it will not break. So for three-piece frame, you should have a polycarbonate glass. What is photochromic lenses? That can change its color to exposure to sunlight. So give you a 100% protection over UV light A and B, and good for all conditions. It is also called day and night lenses. So it can change the color depends upon the light intensity. So when it is CR39, the market people usually say it is called a transition series of lens. Transition means it's a day and night photochromic lens. So SLR company came with a lens that's called, they call it as a transition signature 7 with 100% UV protection as they claim. This is, you can change the, see the color change when it's exposed to sunlight, photochromic properties. They also came with a transition vantage. That means it is more than photochromic, it has a polarized lens also. That means it will protect the glare also. So you can change the color as well as it will have protection and 100% clarity they claim. So polycarbonate lens, refracting this vary from 1.5. It is bulletproof plastic lens. It is called bulletproof plastic lens. The aeroplane or the bulletproof car, they all use this polycarbonate lens. So it is unbreakable, impact resistant, ideal. It is ideal for children, lightweight and UV protector. And the tinting is possible. So Trivex is a variant of polycarbonate. Now it is going out of market. So it is comparatively cheaper than polycarbonate. So this is the CR39 or our ordinary plastic lens. When 500 gram weight is dropped into that, you see it is breaking. Even though the optical shop fellow will say that it will never break, it can break. So if you go to polycarbonate, see the same 500 gram missile is dropped, it is not breaking, it is only just yielding only. So if you want an ideal lens, it should be polycarbonate, especially for children. So what is high index lens? It is high index means refractive index more than 1.5, it can be 1.6, 1.74, etc. It will reduce the thickness. You see the thickness has reduced into half. And due to side distortion, you should have a ARC coating. So you see this is a normal lens and it is with a high index, you can see the thickness has been reduced. And your appearance, your face appearance will be better with a high index lens because the thickness will be half only. Of course, the price will be double. So AS-free high index lens is now available. Refractive index is 1.74. It will reduce all the chromatic aberrations. So AS-free lens, the 20D lens you use for indirect ophthalmoscope, that is the AS-free lens. So that type of lens is now available. So that is ideal for children. It is the world's thinnest plastic lens. So the 40% thinner and 46% lighter. You can compare the normal lens with the AS-free lens. You can see here also what is the difference. It is 46% thinner and lighter. So lens treatment. These are the lens treatment available. Lot of treatments are available. Most cheaper one is called a tinting. And then there is UV coating, then there can be anti-reflective coating or ARC, then scratch resistant coating or SRC. Then transition series of lenses available for CR39 as well as polycarbonate. So that will day and night. The usual color you select is gray or brown. Why should have a protection from sunlight? Because sunlight contains all the UV light, A, B, and C. Luckily, C will be blocked by the ozone layer of the atmosphere. And B will be come up to the cornea, and then it will be blocked by the cornea. But the UV light A will pierce the cornea. It will reach up to the lens or retina. So it is supposed to be one of the reasons for making the cataract. So these are the things. When you're exposed to sunlight, you can have a pterygium, you can have a RMD, or you can have a cataract. So how to protect? This is a base lens, ordinary lens. Over that, you can have a hard coating. Then you can have an ultraviolet coating for against A and B. Then you can have an anti-reflection coating that is based on the seven colors, PBG or seven layers anti-reflection coating. And finally, you can have a hydrophobic or water-resistant coating, so the water will not stick on the over the surface of the lens. So all these coatings are possible over the base lens. You have to specially order for that, and company will give all these things. Of course, it will take 1 or 2 days for this coating. And what is tinting? Tinting is a very common, very natural. You can recommend for working those who are working to exposure to sunlight and everything, because it will cost only hardly 200 to 300 rupees only. The different solutions, it depends upon the color it is available. The optical shop fellow will dip the lens into the solution, keep it for some time. It depends upon the color you want. You can adjust the color, time, everything. The material, color material usually is melanin, SP2, and brown tints are usually used. So depends upon the time of exposure, it will give a different color, different intensity color. All these color combinations are available, gray, brown, red, yellow, orange, photochromic, everything is available. Only probably it may last for 6 months or 8 months only. By that time, it will fade away. Of course, you have to change the glass after 1 year also. So it's comparatively cheaper. Those who cannot go for a photochromic or day and night lens, you can go for a simple tinting or coloring, you can go. What is scratch resistant coating? Because one of the problem with the CR39 is easy to have a scratches. Especially nowadays, people are putting everything in your shirt pocket, mobile, key, car key, plus this your spectacle also. So likely to have a scratches. So you can have a scratch resistant coating to protect your CR39 glass. But it is not a scratch proof. Only some extent only it will give you protection. Reflection on the lens is the main problem, especially for driving and everything, or reading also. There is a two type of light. Light is coming from the bulb, as well as light is reflected from the paper or book you are reading. So two light falling on the anterior surface of the lens, so you can have a reflection. Or when you are driving, so the light will be falling in front of your spectacle from the vehicle coming opposite direction, and light vehicle coming from behind you, light will be falling behind your lens also. So in front light is falling, behind also light is falling. So you have a glare and ghost images. So night driving will be a main problem as you are driving the night. So they can be glare or ghost images because the splitting of the images, light will be falling in the anterior surface as well as posterior surface of the lens. So two images will be formed on the retina. One is the main image and one is a pseudo image. So that will produce a ghost image. So how to have a protection? You should have an anti-reflection coating. So this is an instant ray. If you have an anti-reflection coating, 99.6% of the light will be transmitted, only 0.4% will be reflected, so you have a better quality. That's a property of the advantage of having an IRC coating. So your driving also will be better. This is without coating and this is with coating. You can see that there is a better view with an anti-reflection coating. So here also you can watch this without coating and this is with coating, see the clarity of the vision. So not only the clarity of vision, your appearance, your smartness also will increase. This is glass without coating and this is with the coating. You can see the clarity, your eyes will be shining. So that is your appearance also will be better if you have ARC coating in your glass, and driving also will be more comfortable. So one of the properties with all this polycarbonate and CR39 is the smudging. Or when you touch the glass with your finger, there can be finger mark or the spectacle. So how to protect? You have a hydrophobic coating, so that will prevent the smudging over the lens. Or when you are going for a mist or rain, there is water over the spectacle, so you have a water resistant coating also. Of course, water will fall on the lens, but if you just shake the spectacle, the water will fall away. So that's the properties. So the SLR people came with a lens, they call it a chrysal fort with all these coatings, anti-reflection coating, water repellent, scratch resistant, smudge proof, dust resisting, plus 100% UV protection. All these facilities are available in a single lens. 5 coating will be there. So chrysal prevention, I know financial industry, this is our, what is available in the market only. Chrysal prevention is a new lens. They say that it is give a protection blue, violet, and ultraviolet light also. You can prevent the ARMD or AMD. So one of the things you experience when you come out after driving in the AC car, when you come out, when you just open your door, immediately your spectacle become foggy. So you might have experience. Or when you are enjoying a hot coffee, immediately the vapor will fall on your spectacle. So that then you have to rub your spectacle and everything. So you have a escape, you can escape with that OptiFog coating. So this is called OptiFog activator. You apply over the lens so that no fog will stick on your lens. So no fog, no distortion, and no loss of contrast. So that is also now available. So when you go out on the snow, on the field, or on the hills, this Kashmir, or in the beach, or high hills and etc., they say you have so much sunlight and UV light, so our glare is a main problem. So you can have a protection with that also. You should have a polarized lens. Polaroid is the lens market available in the market. So this is a polarized lens or Polaroid lens. It will be always remain colored. Color will not change. When you go to a room also, it will be have a deep color. So, but for outdoor work, polarized lens is the ideal choice. Previously, it was available only as a single, as a plain glass only. Now it is with power. What all your power, you can be incorporated into the Polaroid lens. Or you can have a progressive lens also. So you can have a progressive Polaroid lens. So that you have 100% protection, as well as 100% protection over the glare and UV light also. Of course, you can see also. Now, usually you use a cooling glass only. Now, photochromic polarized lens is available. So it will be photochromic, that means it will change the color, depends upon the intensity of the color. And as well as it is a polarized, so the glare also will be given. So this ideal lens, photochromic polarized dry wear, that is ideal lens for driving. So 100% protection against UV as well as glare. So usually for sports and games, we usually use a sunglass only. Now sunglasses are available we can be prepared for any power with a photochromic polarized sunglasses now available. Whatever power can be incorporated, you can have a progressive lens also. Whenever you go for outdoor games, especially cricket or all these games when you are going for that, you can have a polarized photochromic progressive lens you can use. Especially for those who are playing for golf and everything, they are all presbyopic age, so you can have a progressive polarized lens. Now it is era for 3D glasses. The TV and the films are coming, and there is a demo of 3D surgery also. So you have to use a 3D glass for the viewing that. Now it came with a polarized 3D glass, so that will give 100% protection over the UV light also. Whenever you want to monitor, see a TV film with a 3D film, you should use a polarized 3D glass. That is also now available. So pediatric refraction is a main problem because you cannot rely on the child. The subjective refraction will be a problem. And the association of strabismus also will be a problem, and the cooperation of the child is also a problem. And after having a refraction, successful refraction, you have subjective things, you prescribe the glasses. How to select the glass, that is also a problem. The children's spectacle is segmented. It is not uniform. There is a male and female, boys and girls spectacle is available. And lens material should be always polycarbonate aspheric lens. You should not compromise. Never glass. If you cannot afford a polycarbonate aspheric, at least go for a CR39. Of course, there will be scratches because children's glass, every year you have to change. So the changing is not a problem. So ideally it should be polycarbonate aspheric, otherwise you go for the IC10 CR39. Now the SLR company came with a new Crystal Kids UV lens. So it is called a new Crystal Kids lens with a UV protection. So children, the UV protector lens is the ideal thing. After giving the spectacle, how to enforce to use the glass? So there should be a correct specification, the proper selection of the frame, good lens and proper fit should be there. And start wearing gradually and make it routine. So if you cannot compel the child, you have to start very slowly. And finally, you should wear every day. And putting eyeglass on and taking them off. You should get training, how to put it, how to take it, and all training. And allow the child to select the frame. That's the most important thing. Take the child for the optical shop and allow the child to take the frame or color or what all things they like. Then they will use. If you select and if you give, they will not use it. So they have to, choice should be given to the child. Then they will start using it also because they like the colorful frame. So when you come to the presbyopia, there is a problem. There's two choices available. You can have a two separate spectacle, one for distance and one for near. So you have to change in between. Otherwise, you can have a glass with one eye for presbyopia and one eye for the distant vision. Then you have a monocular vision. Another choice is you should have a bifocal glass. Then the only problem, you intermediate area, you will not see. So nowadays, people are going for a progressive glass so that you have a distance, you have intermediate, as well as you have a near. So now the prescription presbyopic age, more than 80% people using only progressive glasses. So this is a routine bifocal. When you are morning, you have seeing the TV and reading the newspaper also. In between, your wife has put a beautiful coffee there, but you will miss the coffee unless you are using a progressive glass. Then you will see the coffee also. So when you go for a progressive glass, there's so many factors you have to think. There's a optical center. The optical center should come to the center of the pupil. There's a cross here that is a fitting cross that should be with the upper border of the pupil. And this area is mainly for distant vision, and this area is for the near vision. And there will be a 17 means 1.75, that is addition. That will be remain there permanently. And there's these two marks will be permanently remaining there. That's the engraved circle. So somebody come with a complaint with a progressive glass, you make a line from this spot to this spot. Mark a line and put the frame on the face. And if you see the optical center, if it is coming to the center of the pupil, then that means the fitting is correct. So the optical center will not be marked on the lens. These two spots will be there, the engraved circle, that will be permanent marking on the lens. So make a draw line, and if the line cross the center of the pupil, that means the fitting is correct. Otherwise, the patient will never be happy with the progressive lens. And when you prescribe a progressive glass, the age is about 40 or 45. First time they are using a presbyopic glass, you can have a progressive glass. Somebody using a bifocal glass for the last 20 years, he is 65 or 70, then never prescribe a progressive glass because they are happy with a bifocal glass. Never prescribe a progressive glass for them because motivation is most important for a progressive glass. So first time users, it is okay. For the older generation, never, or senior citizen, never go for a progressive glass. Of course, they can adjust after some training, they can have a progressive glass. Because the progressive glass, the fitting height should be about 18 millimeter, and the overall diameter of the should be about 34 millimeter. Now people want, everybody want a smaller frame, so now the fitting height can be 40 millimeter also. So that means it is about, total diameter should be about 30 millimeter. Then only it will be ideal progressive glass. Another problem with the progressive glass is that all these white areas will be visible. When you go to the side, the blue areas, there will be glare or distortion of the images. So this area for distance and this area for near, and this corridor is for intermediate vision. So there will be a distortion of the images when you go to the periphery. That's a problem with the progressive glass. Sorry, I have a sore throat, pharyngitis. So there's a different design. There's a hard design, soft design, symmetric, asymmetrical, depends upon your occupation. Another problem with the progressive lens is that the distance is clear, near is clear, but two sides will not be clear. So all the beautiful scenes you will be missing. So when you football, you may miss the goal also. You may miss the traffic signal. Unless you use a advanced digital progressive lens, then it will have a more areas will be in the intermediate area. You will not miss the goal or you will not miss the traffic signal. So you should go with advanced digital progressive lens. Of course, the price may be a little high. So the Nova company came with a progressive patientless progressive lens. So they have a different starring, 3-star, 4-star, 5-star, etc. So 5-star lens has a more intermediate area. So the fitting of the progressive glass is very problem. So you have a machine is available, you have a eye anatomy, ergonomics to be measured, and the wrap angle, pantoscopic tilt, pupillary distance, vertex distance, exercise to be measured. So they say to help you, there's a software is available that is called VC Office. You can have all these measurements taken the computer, feed into the computer, and the computer will mark on the lens where the hole, where is the things, how is the fitting, everything. So this software is now available mainly for fitting of the progressive glasses. Now you can order the lens also. It is called a freeform progressive lens. Order the your subjective power, then select the blank, then put into the machine. All the process, they will automatically, it will process. Then all the marking will be on the lens. Then all the coating will be done. Then, and finally, the finished lens will come. So now with the computer help assisted automatic machine is available for making the ideal progressive lenses. So computer eyewear. So they are different from usual glasses. They need special prescription using different lens designs. And they need a special lens treatment also. Optimal visual outcome, comfort and outcome is you're expecting. Otherwise, they will have a computer vision syndrome. So I think Dr. Radhaman will go more on the computer vision syndrome. So computer vision syndrome is a complex of eye and vision problems experienced during computer use. This is a repetitive strain disorder. So they have a headache, eye strain, reading problem, so dry eye, all these things. Because every time you are blinking at least 15, 20 times. When you are in the computer, you put the enter key, then you will be staring at the computer. So the blinking reflexively reduced. So that will produce a dry eye. So you should have a increased blinking, then the normal breath you have to take, and you should have a break in between, micro break, that means 10 second break after every 10 minutes, you got to close the eye for 10 seconds. Mini break means every hour you close the eye for 5 minutes. Maxi break means after coffee break or lunch break, you have a break, go to the toilet, or wash your face and eye, etc. So these are the three ways you can have a escape from the computer vision, and you have the ergonomic, the height of the table, computer height, everything should be adjusted in such a way that ergonomics should be correct. Then only you can escape from the computer vision syndrome. You can have a normal vision spectacle. You can have a combo when you are using a glass. You should use that glass. If you are presbyopic, you use the presbyopic glass. Or there is a special progressive lens that is occupational progressive lenses available. Or you can have a flip focals or clip-on lenses. Or have a pinhole spectacle is also available. What is occupational progressive lens? It's a multifocal aspheric progressive design for both near and intermediate distance. So normal progressive is little intermediate area. In the computer progressive, main area is for distance and near, but the computer progressive, there's a more area is for intermediate area. So the benefits from natural head and neck position, what is available in the market is Calcis, Panorama Mini, SLR, etc. So the SLR company came with a special lens. They call it as a IC10 or workplace lens. They claim that it is ideal lens for computer use. They also came with a standard intermediate lens. That means if you are in the conference or you are in the round table, etc., you should have a standard intermediate area. With this intermediate area will be more. Or there's a standard lens wear that is for any on the office or everything only close area, you have a standard near lens. So it depends upon your occupation, you can select the occupational progressive lens that is available in the market. SLR also came with a lens that is called ISON lens, that is a take care of a rise with the computer vision syndrome with all the protective mechanism, all the coatings, etc. ISON lens or Varilux ISON lens, etc. If you have a presbyopic, you should have a progressive Varilux ISON lens. Or you cannot afford to a computer progressive lens, you can have a clip-on lens or flip lens available. It is detachable additional lens over your spectacle. It is anti-reflecting coating also. You can put it and you can take it out also. Depends upon your use. Or you can have flip focals. You can raise it or bring it down also. That is also available. So device for computer use. So computer eyeglass for people, normal vision also have a glass also now available with a UV protection. And they usually incorporate a 0.25 diopter power so that the accommodation will be a little relaxed. So if you are not using a glass, you can have a computer glass for normal using computer. So the full protection, UV protection, photochromic UV protector glass is available with a 0.25 power. So that is a normal computer glass. So for a computer, you can have a reading glass. That means 200 rupees only in front of the computer. You can use that. That's the most cheapest one. You can see the computer screen very well. Or you can have a bifocal. Only thing you have to raise your chin little. That is also possible. Otherwise, you can have an ordinary progressive glass. Only polar intermediate area will be narrow. You have to rotate your face little in between. Or ideally, you should have a computer occupational progressive glass with office progressive lens. That's the ideal thing for a computer use. So new trend is going on. There can be shell or titanium. Younger generation prefer shell, older generation prefer titanium. The trend is going on. The price also can vary from 1,000 rupees to 50,000 rupees. Optimed, Safilo, Titan are Indian brands. All these are foreign brands. Original as well as duplicate is available. Korean, Chinese duplicate is also available in the market. The price can go up to 50,000. Whenever you buy a frame, you go ask for the guarantee card. So then you can ensure that it is an original frame. Sunglass also can be shell or metal or what all things. Color is available, original as well as duplicate. So all these multiple color with fancy colors are available for children. All these things available in the market. The price can vary from 1,000 rupees to 50,000 rupees. Fast Track, Titan, Ray-Ban, etc. Indian, others are foreign. Only thing you should request for the guarantee card, otherwise it can be duplicate. The lens, there's no lenses manufactured ideal in India. All the lenses are imported. The SLR, Titan, Corning, Calcis, Seiko, these are the brands available in the market. Both CR39, Progressy, everything is available. Now there's a lot of innovations you can attach to the spectacle. So one is iBrowser. This is a software you can download. You can do the Apple computer or Android mobile phone. So you can select your spectacle frame, lens, etc. They will take the photo. The photo can be compared, and the computer will tell you what frame, what size, what is IPD, everything. And you can order the lens. So lens card is playing the market with the IT students. Now the IT people, younger generation, they never go to the optical shop. They will order the lens through lens card using this iBrowser software. So younger generation, now they want to enjoying the music while driving. There's a digital music eyewear. That means in the sunglass, you can fit this digital music eyewear with the iPod. So there's a speaker into the ear with this iPod attached to the leg. So they can enjoy the music without caught by the police. So that's all. The glass is 100% UV protection also. That is available. Now it with the electronic sunglasses available, you can have electronic device in the leg of the cooling glass. Then it will be connected to your mobile phone or MP player, etc. So you can enjoy the music and the Bluetooth connection with your mobile and this device. So you can drive the motorbike or car and enjoy with the Bluetooth, you can enjoy the music, etc. That is electronic sunglass. And then there's a teleglass or a plasma screen effect. They give a pseudo plasma screen effect. One a flat screen of 45 inch TV will cost you about 60,000-70,000 rupees. So with this spectacle and device, you can have an effect of pseudo plasma screen effect. It can be connected to your TV or to your laptop or your desktop or your mobile, etc. with the interface in between, with the Bluetooth or Wi-Fi connection, they can have all these things are possible. With this special spectacle, you can have a pseudo plasma screen effect. Now there's digital sunglasses available with the connector with the interphone. So it is also called a spice and glass. It has a interphone connected with this spectacle, so the spectacle will give 100% protection against UV light, and it is an interphone or telephone is connected, they should have a range of about 500 meters. So those who are working outside in the field or some conference or some sports activities going on, they can have a protection as well as they can communicate with the central office or with the your chief with this speaking through this interphone, so that is also available. So 100% protection as well as you can speak, contact with your office. So those who have a habit of sleeping the afternoon after heavy lunch and everything, so they can have a rousing spectacle. So there's a device attached to your leg of your spectacle. So whenever you are sleepy or bend your head too much, some vibration will be in your ear, on the temples of your ear. You become awake. Of course, there is some safeguard is there. When you bend the head too much only, it will vibrate. Otherwise, it will be a nuisance also. So smart sunglasses are available with the LCD technology that is called smart eyewear or dynamic eyewear. So they have a high resolution camera incorporated. So detect the light from a far distance. So for night driving, that is very effective. And they are used by the Air Force or military people also for detecting plane at a distance with this spectacle with the high resolution cameras. So there is some spectacle research is going on for smart spectacle for see the blind people, for help the blind people, so that they can avoid the white canes or guide dogs, etc. So these spectacles are incorporated with a high resolution multiple cameras and everything. So they will catch the picture from a very, very distance, and it will project in front of the eyes in the posterior surface of the lens. So they can have some idea what is obstacle in front and etc. So it will guide the blind people to have a walk without the help of white cane or guiding dogs, etc. So study is going on. In future, it will come out. So now the extra glasses are also available with the special glasses. You can penetrate, see through your skin or cloth. So that it is, should not be misused, but it can be used for identifying the veins, for taking veins and everything, because the younger doctors, they don't know how to take the vein and everything, IV pricking and everything. So with this spectacle, they can have a clear view of the vein and everything. So that is called X-ray glasses. So now it is a market, Google glasses available. A computer can be incorporated into your spectacle with a small CPU, battery, speaker, and camera. That is called Google glasses, but now, it has not the shape of a spectacle. It can be have an internet connection and so it can guide you for GPS direction for driving and everything. It has a built-in camera also. So it can be medicine also, it can be used especially for angioplasty surgery and everything. So that type of Google spectacle with a computer attachment is also available. Because the shape is not with the spectacle, so they have a collaboration with the Luxottica group of companies, so they have a spectacle shape and everything incorporated with the device, computer device over the leg of the spectacle, and it is connected with the Bluetooth into the mobile application. There's another competitor that's called Lumus DK40. That's the biggest competitor for Google Glasses. So they use the Android platform for these things. It is Android platform they are using. So there are all researches going on. In future, the computer will be in your spectacle. And there's Ion goggles are now available. They have a high resolution HD camera is incorporated into these things. They give 100% perfection. This is a perfect gadget for adventurous sports, skydivers, to record the breathtaking views. So they have 100% protection plus high resolution HD cameras. They take going on taking photos or videography. So all the adventurous events will be recorded. So that type of spectacle is now available. Now to replace spectacle, IC10 camera or pinhole camera is coming. So you can thin lenticule can be implanted into the cornea during LASIK surgery, just like our smile procedure. So you put some lenticule into the cornea, so the pinhole effect, so the refractive error will be corrected. That's also going on in Japan, research is going on in Japan. So computer can be also be used to selection of spectacle also. So this is called iPoint software is available. You can incorporate in the computer. So they go on taking multiple photos. So patient can compare different images. At least 4 or 8 images they can take and they can compare which is available. They can share with email. They can internet communicate with their wife or husband at Dubai and select the frame. So that's possible. You can have a frame selection, lens contact lens selection. And you can have a, what is the thickness of the lens, weight of the lens, etc. can be compared. You can select it for contact lens also. And you can see what is your appearance with the spectacle after fitting, or how the appearance you can see on the computer. The fitting of the lens is the most important problem. You have all the measurement. Dr. Radhaman will go more details into that. So then only the ideal fitting, then otherwise you have all the problem with the spectacle. So what are the spectacle indolence? Dr. Radhaman will talk you. Now a machine is available for fitting of the spectacle also. This first machine, you put the, your frame and the lens into this machine. The computer will analyze the frame and lens. They have, everything will be recorded. Then they put the lens into the second machine. Then the second machine will do the edging of the lens. And you make a holes for three-piece frame fitting and everything. So with this, everything will be automatic machine is available. Then the technician's work is only to tighten the screw. That's only into the frame. So everything automatic machine is now available. So in conclusion, spectacles are very personal to every individual. Wide choice are available in frame and lens. The selection depends upon the lifestyle, occupational condition, visual needs, and taste and budget. So special lens designs, coating, and tinting gives good result. So at least a protection from UV light, glare, and reflections are essential. You use only quality lens, that means branded lens. Ultimate success of refraction depends on the quality of vision experienced by the end user in non-clinical atmosphere. Eye care professional can play a vital role here. So most important thing, prescription of lens should be correct. So as a doctor, you have two roles. The prescription should be correct, and you have to give the proper direction to the customer, what is the things available in the market. And finally, the wearer should see well and look good also. So our ultimate aim is see better, look better, feel better, and live better. So thank you very much.